Okay, so today we are gonna do Cold Gin and by Kiss, I guess. And yeah, so this was suggested to me because I like Ace Frehley so much, and apparently he contributed a lot to the song. He wrote it, and he plays guitar on it. Anyway, so yeah, and I love me some Ace Frehley and Kiss, I guess, as well. So yeah, we're gonna get into this now, talk about it after. So let's get going now. Ready to go. Right, so Kiss and Cold Gin. Okay, I have to say, okay, I liked that a lot. I thought it was, I liked many parts of it. I guess I should get into that. So Ace Frehley, obviously, like I said, I like him a lot on guitar. I liked his playing, especially there during the instrumental break, and just the whole dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun, I like that a lot. Almost like they were kind of playing back and forth. I guess each, I guess, you know, Gene and Paul and Peter. And also, I like Peter, especially on the end there, how he finished the song, I guess, on drums. I like Peter. I know a lot of people, you know, I hear that, you know, Peter Criss. I know there was a Family Guy episode I watched even before I even know who Kiss was. But, you know, there's a lot of Peter Criss jokes. And, you know, nobody wants to dress up as Peter Criss, not even Peter Criss, all this stuff. Yeah, it's just, I don't know. As just like a new Kiss fan, I think he sounds all right. I like his playing. I mean, I listened to Beth. I never heard that before, but I thought that was sweet. And yeah, I just like his drum fills, and I just like the way he plays with you know, especially with Ace. And I guess there's always been that thing, it seems anyway, that it was like Ace and Peter, I couldn't think, and against, you know, Paul and Gene. You know, Paul and Gene were kind of more, I guess, you know, serious, and that really showed in interviews, you know. Yeah, so I don't know. I like each player, and also Gene was on vocals here, but I don't know if he was doing, because, you know, in the intro when it says "woo, all right," that sounded like Paul to me. I want to say Paul was doing that, and then also after the instrumental when he went "whoa, yeah," and just Gene's, I guess his, you know, persona is the demon. And he just sounded kind of like it here, like, you know, with his, where was the part, when he was singing in this, where the heck, in the second verse, when it said, you know, it's time to leave and get another quart, and I just like the way he said it like quart, and then also he said another word, when he said tired, he said it kind of differently there as well. But yeah, when he says, you know, ha ha, the cheapest stuff is all I need. But just the way he says, you know, ha ha, it was like, ha ha. It's just like, you know, it's like he's already drunk. He sounds just, yeah, demonic. It just sounds so deep and vulgar. And I just like that a lot. And then the whole to get me back on my feet again. And you know, the just the line, the cheapest stuff is all I need. It's just like, I know a few people like that. But anyway. And a few of them are 6 feet under. So then, you know, with the outro again, I just love how wild the voice sounds. You know, just like, you know, it'll always win. It's Cold Gin time again. You know, it's the only thing that keeps us together. Ow. And then we go out. Just a heck of a song. Yeah, so I guess there are, you know, some stuff about the song. There is some stuff about the song. So the about on genius.com. So it says here, one of the earliest of Ace Frehley's contributions to Kiss's catalog, Cold Gin was written by Frehley on subway trips to and from Kiss's rehearsal loft in New York. This is one of multiple instances where Frehley did not sing lead on his own song due to his lack of confidence. So Gene Simmons takes the vocal instead. I did not know that about Ace, his lack of confidence. I guess, yeah, I mean, yeah, especially, I know Ace, especially, I mean, my favorite song, I think, probably, that I've heard, I guess, at this point, by Kiss would be, crap. Shock Me. You know, I get on, I freaking start the video, and everything goes blank, and it's just like, I don't know why. Anyway. So then the personnel, it's the basic, it's, you know, the original Kiss members, all four of them, released in 1974. And then, yeah, but there is some also some other stuff here on song facts. We have Ace Frehley, what he said. So it says basically, he explained, I wrote Cold Gin in a New York subway in my head, both lyrics and music. I had a spiral book with me. I never took a guitar lesson, nobody believes that. And I have heard that before in interviews with Ace, where he just says, yeah, he was self-taught, which is pretty cool. I didn't realize it was going to become a Kiss classic. And that's, you know, usually those kind of songs can have a tendency to become classics, I guess, just the ones that are on a whim. Gene Simmons said, Ace Frehley brought in Cold Gin. When we first heard it, I remember being struck by that great opening guitar riff. And also, I want to say, which is the basis of the song, the guitar riff at the start, it reminds me of another song. I was thinking like Smoke on the Water, but that does not sound like it. It's like, I don't know what it is. But it's kind of like a, you know, I feel like if I said it's a basic kind of sound, I feel like that's being critical of it because I like the sound of it. But yeah, it's like, I don't know what it is. It sounds like another song, or it just sounds like, you know, one of those kind of smoke in the water, you know, a song you can learn as your first song or something, which, because I did read that somebody did, Rivers Cuomo of Weezer, it says here in Song Facts, he learned this song. It was his first song he ever learned on guitar. And it just seems like one of those songs that you could just learn easily. I don't know. Maybe not easily, but you know, because Ace Frehley was a complex guitarist. He still is. I guess he's not dead. Anyway, it goes on. Gene Simmons said, the problem we had with it was after the verse and chorus, it didn't seem to go anywhere. It was an unfinished idea. I suggested a section in the middle of the song that became the riff part of the song. It changed the song from an A voicing to a riff section in the key of G and kept ascending up the scale until it finally wound up in an E. Paul suggested a couple of arrangement modifications in the song, and presto, Cold Gin, the complete song. I insisted that Ace should sing the song, but he refused and said that he preferred I sing it. I sing it. Why can't I talk? The original version of the song, as recorded on the Kiss demo, changed very slightly through the years and was to remain a staple of live concerts to this day. The irony of the song is that Gene Simmons, who sings it, doesn't drink and never. And has never done drugs. Well, my goodness. Simmons claims that the only thing he was ever addicted to was sex and that he slept with over 4,000 women. Well, I hope he's been checked. The song was played at the funeral of late guitarist Dimebag Darrell Abbott, as Kiss and Ace Frehley were his favorite band and guitarist. Well, that's pretty cool. And yeah, Dimebag Darrell, I mean, he was one of the greatest guitarists of all time. Pantera, good lord, he's unmissable. But anyway, that was a nice gesture, but again, I would like to hear. Even though I said I love Gene's voice and everything, I don't hate it or whatever. I would like to hear what Ace sounds like on it. He's probably done it live. He's probably done something about it, but I don't know about it because again, this is just my first time hearing this song. So yeah, I mean, my God, it's a great drinking song, I guess you could say. obviously, the whole thing, basically, you know, the drinks, you know, the gin, I guess the cold gin is basically all this person has left. You know, my heater's broken, I'm so tired, I need fuel to build a fire. The girl next door, her lights are out, but the landlord's gone, I'm down and out. It's cold gin time again, you know, it'll always win in the end. You know, it's just, you know, that kind of, I guess, you know, lonely kind of thing, you know, drinking by yourself. You know, the whole George Thorogood and the all that stuff. I drink alone, you know, that kind of a feeling. So yeah, I like the song a lot. I don't know what else to say. Anyway, I guess that's it. So thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting. Really appreciate all the support. And yeah, I enjoyed this Kiss song a lot. Wild vocals and great instrumental break as well. And I think Peter Criss is pretty good. Anyway, I guess that's it. Thanks for watching again. I'll talk to you guys again soon.